not go into technicalities of the subject, but when I try to explain to you certain provisions of law, the practical tips which you can start implementing from today itself, be it related to conveyance, stamp duty, registration, redevelopment, modalities of corporate society. As regards redevelopment, used by explained to us in a very nice manner, the precautions to be taken, I would like to draw your attention to two tips. Point number 179 circular is indirectly made compulsory by our cooperative BMC officers. BMC, universally speaking, always stands for Bachelors and Masters of Corruption. One of the conditions of IOB that has been stipulated is compliance of circular 79A. As regards BMC, our ex-CM, who is also surname was Deshmukh, always used to say, standing committee of the corporation is an understanding committee for the betterment of the corporation. And we appreciate his understanding of the subject, being a retired chief minister himself. In our cooperative societies, we time and again talk of bylaws. In simple terminology, what is bylaws? By to law is bylaws. Many committee members, office bearers will talk of bylaw number so and so. And what will members say? Bylaws are the manosai. And reality is, it is not bylaw, but bylaw. Classic examples of the same are beer bars and builders. Which builder complies with the laws of the land is a $1 million question. I will request our DTR to share this experience. Now we can take our side because we know more than DTR. I have no hesitation in saying that not even 5% of the compliances under Section 79A are complied in letter and spirit. There is absolutely no hesitation. In fact, there is no record being maintained by the Office of the Deputy Registrar of Cooperative Societies except for granting permission, is my personal view. When we look at the fine prints of Section 79, the permission being granted as per the cooperative circular, the crux of the issue is bank guarantee of 20% of the project cost has to be given. I have not come across a single case in any DTR office or at any from any builder in my area of practice of so many years, who had even taken the trouble of working out the entire project cost. I have not seen any 20% bank guarantee being given, which is law by itself. MADA has insisted, and so has the BMC insisted, that you have to give 20% bank guarantee, comply with the 79A directives. And 79A directives talks that 20% bank guarantee of the project cost has to be given by the developer. Builder ka matlab kya hai? Bina jo dar nahi, the builder. Buy bank manje buy garant ya bank hoga. Similarly, for the builder, cooperative department is one more table, nothing more. Is my personal feeling as far as the modalities of the development comes. The crux of the issue is the failure of the system. I repeat, we have to see for the failure of the system, and I repeatedly ask the CM and Chief Secretary on various occasions by letters, is it not something wrong with the system that in 1964 the MOFA has come and today we are in 2015? And what is the ratio of the convenience being received? Not even 10%. What is my government doing from 1964 till today? What is the PMC doing? If we look at the right information obtained, not even 10% of the properties being developed in Mumbai have the building completion certificate. Why our sleeping giants PMC are not taking these things as policy decisions? I am not against one developer or one officer. They are small people in the whole system. The crux of the thing is we have to do something whereby this system has a self-check introduction automatically in the system, so that no person will try to exceed his limit, and even if he tries to exceed his limit, automatically there is a simple thing. We have been looking, there was another speaker talked about the new law, which is the Housing Regulatory Act. Somehow the powerful builders, in spite of tall promises from center and state, they have ensured that that law is not gone. There is no need of bringing new laws. Only the existing laws required to be tightened. Why this deep conveyance debt, which we normally call it as debt conveyance or doomed conveyance? Why such things are allowed to remain? Why do you want the hearing? The law is very clear, within 4 months he has to give a conveyance. I am not supposed to sign the conveyance. A cooperative society, you are not supposed to sign the conveyance also. You are not supposed to give a single information. Builder is a party to your agreement. Your law stipulates that for 1 year a flat cannot be transferred. The time limit is 4 months from the date of formation of cooperative society that builder has to give conveyance. Section 11 of the Mumbai Act stipulates promoted to convey title, etc. The focus is in the definition itself, the head note, convey, title, etc. Anything and everything connected to property being conveyed has to be done by the promoter. Convey means not conveyance. Conveyance is a small fragment of the right which a flat purchaser is entitled to. Your focus, in my view, should be on getting the property card transferred in your name. Your focus should be on getting the property tax bill transferred in your name. Your focus should be on getting the water bill transferred in your name. Your focus should be on getting the original documents of title to the property. Your focus should be on getting the audited statement of accounts. Your focus should be on building completion certificate. Why is it that 10% of the properties also in Mumbai are not having the building completion certificate? These facts and figures are obtained under the Right to Information Act from the Bombay Municipal Corporation. Don't go for peanuts, X officer, Y officer, he is not doing his duty. That's the part of your fight. Your fight is like the eye which Arjun saw in a bird. I want property card transferred in my name. And the best way is to approach the consumer forums, consumer courts for deficiency of service and unfair trade practice. You will be surprised that even a single member of your society can approach the consumer courts for getting the conveyance, making the cooperative society and the builder a party. If you go as a cooperative society, on an average, it will not take more than 2 years to get it. And the results are amazing. Here we have one member from Omega City, Mr. Jayesh Bhai. We got more than 1 lakh rupees there as compensation. Apart from that, State Commission, it was rejected with an observation that this compensation is negligible. Immediately after getting conveyance order from a consumer court, initiate proceedings under Section 25 and Section 27 of the Consumer Protection Act. In Section 27, the builder can be jailed. The pressure is immense. depends on the builders. And here you can see the best of the builders pleading at consumer court because they, it's a sure shot win for a cooperative society as there is a clear-cut violation of statutory obligation. We are talking so much about deed conveyance. I had the occasion of discussing this matter with the Principal Secretary Corporation and senior officers of housing as well as revenue. And my submission was specific. With utmost respect to you, please educate me when Transfer of Property Act is the Central Government Act. Indian Registration Act is the Central Government Act. There are no amendments in the Central Acts for this deed conveyance thing. How can deed conveyance provisions be implemented in lateral spirit? And a very evasive reply was given to me that as far as I am concerned, I have got consent from President, so I am not bothered. Whether that submissions are right or wrong is not my concern because the President has approved it. Any student of law will tell you that in the Central Act, state government cannot do much. It has to be regulated through the central government because center is in power. And till today, there is no amendment in Central Government Acts, Indian Registration Act or the Transfer of Property Act. The provisions of law which can successfully in a fraction of a second result in implementing conveyance related things are very simple. Blacklist the builder who has not given you conveyance earlier at the housing department level, have a form asking for the details of the construction activities being done by the builder, the conveyance being given, and until and unless those things are not given, don't pass any further IOD of that builder, the director's partners. Make some of the offenses cognizable offenses instead of non-cognizable, and you don't have to implement any law. These two exercises which are sufficient. If the government is serious and they implement it, nothing more is required. But everyone knows that politicians are in the pocket of builders because builders are silent partners, sleeping partners, invisible partners in many projects of builders. It is an open secret. And that is the reason why they are going slow. I may share with you one judgment of the Supreme Court of French colony of Fata. Specifically, it has been stated, relevant some questions I may quote. It is common knowledge that builders enter into underhand dealings and deviations are being done by them. If such deviations are done, one can safely presume that they have been done intentionally as builders are supposed to know the law in a better manner since they are dealing with the same regularly. A special committee formed to highlight the wrongful things being done, a high-powered committee by the government, and which will educate and take steps to set aside these things. These are the gist of the things of this judgment. But in principle, nothing is being followed or implemented. As members of cooperative society, I will share with you a few things. If you have got a problem, you should know how to voice your problem. Just as ladies prepare food, they put achar, they add masalas to the food to make it tasty. Same way, friends, I will insist upon you that if you have any complaints, you should know how to dramatize your complaint and assert your right. The best way is form groups of your minority. If you are the majority, that complaint would have immediately been implemented. So we'll go with the presumption you are a minority. One person should approach registrar. One person should approach cooperative court. One person should approach consumer. The reason of the same is when you are approaching three authorities and even if one government authority is helping you, it automatically strengthens your view. You should know where to attack, how to attack, and above all, when to attack. First, allow that to come at a point then start your real examination, so that he, your insistence on getting certain things is definitely given higher priority. For example, car parking. Everyone knows builder has no right to sell car parkings. Builders sell car parking. Allotment is the name given. In just 5 kilometers from here at Vikhroli Godrej Group, the directors, Firoz Shah Godrej and Manik Engineer, process was issued against them just for charging 5,000 or 15,000 for the sale of a car. They may have quashed it from the High Court, but the point is, for a small negligible amount, industrialist process was issued on the industrialist. We are only looking at piecemeal benefits. If your committee is not doing the work properly, there is no reason why you should approach the Register of Cooperative Societies under Section 83 and 88 of the Master Cooperative Societies Act, which my learned friend will take up the issue in his speech. This is a 24/7 hanging soul of the managing committee members. With your admonition, you can straightway individual member write a letter to the managing committee member stating that we reserve our right to approach the cooperative board with the prayer for the appointment of a board commissioner on the flag of a managing committee member. My colleague Ita Patia, who is well versed in practically every leading matter, she is directly or indirectly associated in cooperative board, will share with you the powers of cooperative board and how you can take the managing committee to task in cooperative board. This is a way whereby you are creating some fear on the managing committee. Managing committee members like builders are visiting faculty in the life of a building. The moment the managing committee member, MC, like the municipal commissioner, they are respected only as long as they are in power. The moment they are stepping down of the meeting and after that tenure, definitely the roles change. Same way, the managing committee member, when he leaves the meeting and goes to his house, you should know how to use his spouse as your PRO. The invisible fear of a board commissioner on the flag of a managing committee member will compel him or at times tame him to toe the line of justice, whereby the misuse of power being done, be it in the nature of levy or focus, amounts as penalty. You can straightway take the managing committee members to court, particularly criminal court for abuse of power, for extortion, criminal breach of trust. My co-speaker Ramesh Chheda will share with you the ways and means by which managing committee members have several responsibilities which you are not aware of. Let me give you a simple example. All of our societies are having securities, and those securities, any quotation, is the primary target on which the decision is taken. As per Section 4 of the Security Guard Code, that security is supposed to be registered with the police authorities. Very, very, very few security agencies, numbering not more than 50 in Maharashtra or in Bombay, are registered. Why are they not being registered? Because of the laws, stringent laws like Minimum Wages Act. The salary that has to be paid to the security guard is mind-blocking if they are registered. Minimum Wages Act. So this is the responsibility cast on the managing committee members. And in one of our societies where the minority had some dispute, this was taken straightway in the criminal court, and the security agency was told to remain in court till the rising of the court, besides a hefty fine of 25,000. If you know where to strike and what to strike, it is very helpful. The classic things recently, recent development is of the legal and metrology department. If there is some shortage of that area, first offense, the builder can get away by paying some fine. But for the second offense, subsequent offences, it is a criminal offence for which he has compulsorily to go to jail, for which even now recently FIR has been lodged against Oberoi Realty and many other builders. Some flats have also been seized. The winds of change are coming, and if you plan your strategy, your focus should not be just on speaking. You should know when to attack, where to attack, and the biggest tool, a biggest inexpensive tool, I would say, is the Right to Information Act, which is your Brahmastra. You can take to task any government officer by asking information, and how to ask information is also an art. If you are talking of BMC, ask for the papers related to the relevant subject matter, and whichever things are left vacant, by the Bombay Municipal Corporation intelligent officers should be the place where you have to focus your energy. Instead of asking questions directly related to your things, make it difficult for him by asking questions where we know he is on a slippery wicket. Let me share with you a few things. Say, we are going to one particular government department, without naming that department. Ask him questions, which are the registers that have got to be maintained by him. Ask him questions. Drafting is also a skill. If you ask a straight question, it will be rejected under RTI Act. So your sentence should always begin, as per record, anything you are asking, the meaning will remain the same, but it is being framed in such a way, as per record, please provide the various registers to be maintained by you. As per records, please provide the date till which each and every register has been maintained. As per record, please provide details of missing file. Coming on the missing file, it is the duty of the officer to trace out the file. And whenever you get a reply, they will not say file is missing. They will always say file is not traceable. In reality, there are hundreds of documents at the registration office which are lost, not traceable. I'll share with you one of my cases. A client came to me for 20 years, his document was not traceable. Her registered agreement, endless letters being received, written, no response. When he came to me, I told my son Mithil to file a simple application under RTI. That application was filed, and as usual in some waste paper department of the bureaucrat, it must have gone. Instead of going by the pleading route or normal route, what we did is that 10 rupee court fee, one copy was addressed to Pune office, IPR office, and another copy was addressed to the Bombay office, and it was addressed from the Rajawadi post office, hardly half a kilometer from here. Because I had paid 10 rupees as court fee, in the eyes of law, I became a consumer. And because I am a consumer, I had the power to invoke the provisions of the Consumer Protection Act. So I got summons issued from Bandra, which is the Bandra Consumer Additional Consumer Dispute Redressal Forum, which is the authority to entertain consumer disputes. From here I got summons issued at Pune of the concerned office, and I called that officer at Bandra Forum. With lightning speed, in 10 days I got a letter from Pune that after a Herculean search, we have found your document and you please come and collect it. In 10 rupees I have been able to get these works done. Apart from that officer filing at least 7 to 8 times, he must have come to Bandra from Pune. I am happy because client is happy. The point I am trying to tell you is, these are brahmastras for you. Right to Information Act, Right to Services Act. Please remember, officer is a servant, public servant, and give him full respect, appreciate his difficulty, but at the end of it, he is a public servant and is there to serve you. There is a time limit on him to do a particular work. If he is not doing, you may have a stereotype format of letter from Chief Minister to Chaprasi in the government. Any person doing your work is your godfather. You don't have to be bothered by his technicalities, whether it's an IAS officer, known for saying, I am sorry, whatever it may be. You are a taxpayer, and with your money, the tax money, his salary is coming. So ultimately, he is the public servant, and he is bound by certain obligations on him. We are unnecessarily giving more and more importance to government officers who at times are teaching us as their servants. So we have to be very ruthless, very firm, and call him at our place. Don't hesitate, he is busy. What for he may be busy? You should come and inspect the premises in person. You come here, why should I come to your office? It is not necessary for you to go to that office. At times, let me share with you, you write letter, address it from the Chief Secretary, Chief Minister, all these things. Catch the officer at Lokshahi and the results will be very good. It will be a unique experience for yourselves to see. Rather than listening to 50 people, call that officer in Lokshahi and ask him in front of collector, why my work has not been done and what he has done, let him give me a day-to-day report of it. You should throw away your fear of an officer and be blunt, be specific, and you will see the difference in results. You are a taxpayer, and just as I mentioned that ladies know how to make the food tasty, so should your letter, specifically my advocate friends and all those friends who are writing letters. You have got a lot of inputs, so dramatize the facts. Let me give you one instance of it. If you are writing a letter to Bombay Municipal Corporation, instead of coming straight to the point, you emphasize, just open Google search and look at the budget of Bombay Municipal Corporation. It is 3,400 crores. So you start your letter that the budget of this particular department is so much crores that I feel that this money is being wasted by inefficient persons. You start a letter highlighting the role of the public. He is a representative of the government of India. You say you are a representative of the government and the government has high expectations from you. Let it be up to you. It doesn't make a difference. No harm in assuming certain things. So when you are writing a letter, the focus of the letter should be that legal injury is caused to you. You are doing certain duty by writing a letter. Because of the negligence of that government officers, you are forced to devote your time for which you are not going getting any salary. That has to be the focus and intensity of your letter. And instead of providing all the materials handy to that officers, always write the second letter in continuation of my letter dated so and so. So that officer will have to search, call for the earlier letter. That will add to his work. And when you are asking for information in the RTI, don't provide him any letter information. Let him search out, let him do his duty because he has got certain time limits. So he will be forced to look at the file. And I'm not suggesting, but if you have written one or two dates letter wrongly, so you can amount, think of the research being done by him at the government offices to find out which is your letter, that your name will definitely become famous. Don't give your mobile number in that letter. Only write email ID. A typical reply you will get, you come to our office. You should be blunt. Why should I come to your office? You are getting salary. You come to my place if you want information. And in all probability, even without charging the respective fees, you will get the necessary information at your place. You have a wealth of persons. Same complaint, again and again you can file. You can file it through different people. So this has to be your approach. As far as the modalities of conveyance are concerned, the best way is to, in my view, is to approach the consumer courts with prayers linked from building completion certificate, getting all the details, stamp duty, registration done of all the earlier agreements. St- is the second highest source of revenue for the authorities. When you are registering an agreement, you are within your rights to make multiple copies of the agreement and get it registered. So that apart from one agreement having the maximum stamp duty amount, 100 rupees additional copies can be obtained by you and kept for yourselves. In the days to come, when you are applying for a bank loan, at that time 100 rupees registered document, you can submit it. Government is literally blackmailing the persons pertaining to stamp duty by demanding stamp duty on the market value of the property. Writ petition number 550 of 1994, Mundra versus State of Maharashtra, consent petition has been filed, where Government of Maharashtra has given an undertaking that we will not use the ready act now while calculating the stamp duty. It is an open secret that stamp duty is collected on the market value of the property. Any Tom, Dick and Harry connected with real estate will tell you that carpet area and built-up area cannot be generalized. Stamp duty is collected on the built-up area. Built-up area will vary from builder to builder and from project to project. It cannot be generalized. Yet what has our intelligent officers at stamp duty office done? They have said that whatever is your carpet area, you just add 20% of it, so it will become built-up area. For calculation of built-up area, one has to see the plot of land, the quantum of construction, the open space that is being left, and on that built-up area is worked out. So even if I am a builder, I construct two building A and building B. It may be adjoining or in any part of Maharashtra. The ratio of carpet area to built-up area for both my buildings can be different. So the stand being taken by the Maharashtra government, Maharashtra stamp duty to even CD of lands, this has been exercised by them on some occasions. So please, when you are purchasing a flat, you have to insist and ensure that the entire chain of documents is properly stamped and registered. Property involves very fine points, like it is a freehold land or a leasehold land. If it is even collector's land, there are many negative covenants. My friend Gendra gave me a copy of the notification, and you will be happy to know that the notification dated 30th June 2015 has removed the income criteria. There was a Mohammad Tughlaq rule that if you want to purchase, that was what the law of our collectors had framed and kept it, which now they have rectified. So now, as far as the income criteria is concerned, definitely it is a good thing. We are here at Ghatkopar, and all these properties which we are seeing, we have a cooperative society, we feel we are happy. But you should look at the property card, and when E1 is appearing, it stands for collector's land. You have to pay collector's premium, you have to take collector's permission, then only officially your flat gets transferred. Just because your cooperative society has transferred the flat, that has no legal validity. In fact, collector's land, unless permission is not obtained, that transaction itself is in limbo, and collector has got powers to even seal your building and take vacant and peaceful possession of the premises. They have threatened many people that we will take away your land, but ultimately political compulsions compel the builders, compel the bureaucrats not to go very fast. However, in some cases, they have insisted for 50% of the difference in the value to be deposited in High Court. So there are powers, there are restrictions. Normally for flats and cooperative society, 250 rupees per square feet is the limit. But for redevelopment and all those things, the conditions are worst, and only influential people are able to manage. You have to see for your problem specific hard hitting things, and one of the best ways to ask the officers to give how orders are passed in the last 2 months. There may be one application made 3 days ago and immediately today an order is passed. But there are some applications made 3 years ago, no one has even bothered to look at it. Friends, one more thing is, you should not have an impression that because you have filed nomination, everything is complete. Nominee is a trustee of the flat. You have to file a will drafted. You don't have to go to a lawyer for it. Just start one sentence. All my properties to my wife by this my will. Take signature of 2 people except your wife, and it is absolutely a valid will. You don't have to have it stamped, you don't have to have it registered. On the redevelopment aspect, one other thing which I would like to share is, don't talk to builder in terms of extra area alone. Area has to be measured in terms of length, breadth and height. Always insist on the existing height to be given to you, so that over the span of time, you are able to keep many of your goods in a way that you are comfortable. While drafting an agreement with the builder, Piyushbhai has nicely explained the things that have to be taken into consideration. I would like to add 2 more things to it. One is, always in the development agreement, you should have an exit clause, so that notwithstanding anything to the contrary, if the builder is not completing the project with OC by so and so date, we can terminate the contract. This termination clause will help you immensely. It is the mother of all clauses. There will be a lot of WWF between the society and the builder. And one thing which I have seen is, many times managing committee members are refined estate agents or representatives of the builder, knowingly or unknowingly. Not necessary for the sake of money, but they may just share our information, they may just pass on some vital things, and they may help in protecting the builder's interest. What should be your policy in redevelopment? Few persons should irritate the developer. Few persons should be nice with him. For example, as Piyushbhai mentioned, shortlisting of developer. If out of 10 developers, 1 developer is rejected, then intentionally try and be friendly, some members in your society, with the developer who has been rejected. Get information from him. Again, on a will, try to free you. You please help us in guiding what are the wrong things being done so that I can properly represent it in the committee. Play the same game of the developer with the developer. One developer against the other. Your weak points, the weak points of the developer will be understood nicely by the other developer. One of them is co-donation of open space, stack parking. I have seen developers speaking, I have said I will provide a box grill. I have not said I will provide a sliding window. To that extent, they go when it comes. Because the moment you have handed over the possession of your flat, your position is like a girl's father. You are helpless. You have to go to his dictates, and the only document that is going to protect you is your development agreement and your individual members' agreement. I go to that extent, don't vacate the premises until you have your individual members' agreement. Today, you are occupying flat number 101. Tomorrow, after redevelopment, you are going to get flat number 301. Now, when you want to sell your flat 301, the purchaser will ask you title, and you don't have any documents of title. Builders, for the sake of saving a few rupees of stamp duty, will not even attach draft this agreement. But the quantum of difficulties that will be faced by you in future is immense. At that time, the builder has gone, the committee has changed, and you will be the sufferers. The fine print is important. Don't permit a developer to have stack parking, because stack parking can be used to drive roads only. So that is practically a 24/7 recurring expense on you. For the delays being committed by the developer, have per member per day penalty. That amount of 1 lakh or 2 lakhs being spoken in managing committee and general body is in aggregate. You break up that amount into per member per day, so that amount will not appear a big amount. Have we wondered that the only qualification for being a builder is a sweet tongue and a smiling face? Builder will say, yes, yes, Vikram ji, mere ko ek baar position do, phir main dikhata hoon main kya cheez hoon. This is the policy of the builder. My alarm has come, so I don't have to see the alarm. Thank you, friends. I should continue.